Hey guys, how's it going? This is David Kwan. So I know it's been quite a while. I think I say that every time I sit down and record myself now. It's been a while. Yeah, it's been a while because I've been really busy, as I mentioned before in my last channel update blog. And it's been kind of, I'm still kind of adjusting. I think I'm much better adjusted now to this kind of schedule of having classes, 3 classes on Saturdays, and then doing my internship 21 hours a week, and my part-time job, which is I'm trying to count the hours that I do. I do 2 days of my part-time job, and it's from like I go to school from 9 in the morning, and I end up with my part-time job at like 3, sometimes 3:30. It really depends. So that's kind of what I got going for me. And Sunday, ironically enough, Sunday I go to church, and I'm there from morning till like, by the time I get home from church, it's like 5 in the afternoon. So that's kind of my weekly schedule at this point. I'm not going to really explain the whole church going thing. That's probably a topic for another video, but it's really just to appease my parents. That's pretty much it. And also, the community that I see in church is not bad. You know, good people. I like, you know, interacting with new people. So there's that going for it. But I think one of the hardest things for me was, you know, becoming a morning person, because my schedule now forces me to be a morning person. And I've never really been that great at being a morning person. At certain points in my life, I had to be. But in the recent past, like, I didn't have to be. In the recent past, I worked as a homeless shelter. I worked at a homeless shelter, not as a homeless shelter. Sorry. Really bad wording. I worked at a homeless shelter, and it was the night shift. So I worked from midnight to morning. Sometimes a double shift would mean midnight to 4:30 in the afternoon. That's a double shift. And that happened a lot when I worked at a homeless shelter, unfortunately. But, yeah. So, you know, having been so used to that, and then going from that to door-to-door canvassing, which, you know, the hours where I start working at like 1:30 in the afternoon and I end at like 10 at night, you know, a lot of that has been ingrained in me. So like the biological clock that I have was still really used to that. But now being forced to be a morning person, because my internship requires that I get to the high school by 8:30 in the morning. So I have to leave home by at least by 7:30, because it's an hour-long commute. I have to take a bus there, and the bus is a long distance. And my part-time job, which is being a classroom tutor at an elementary school, I have to be there by 9 o'clock in the morning. It's kind of flexible. I could sometimes be there 9:30, sometimes be 9:20. But generally speaking, I should be there by 9, which again forces me to be a morning person. And then my 3 classes that I have on Saturdays, the first class that I have takes place at 8 in the morning. So I have to leave by 7. So again, now a lot of folks out there might not see this as a big deal. A lot of people wake up at 5 in the morning. They have to wake up at 4 in the morning to go to work and to go to school and all that. Mad props to you. But I'm just saying that for me, it's been quite a challenge to force myself to be a morning person. But I think, you know, biological clock is one of those things where, you know, you kind of get used to it. You get used to the routine and it settles in and you adjust to it. So I'm finally kind of hitting that stage where I'm getting used to it. Although it was very challenging. I think one of the things that really pointed to me that was like super the fact that it was challenging to me, like I noticed, because like last week I got a cold sore, and that's like one of those when you have like these big holes in like near the inner gums of your mouth. Oh man, it was really big. It was really painful. Every time I talked, every time I ate, it was just like, arr, it hurts. I was scared to eat solid food. Because it just hurts so much. Like, it's been a long time since I ate, like, a salad. And that's like, I eat salad, like, almost every day, being vegetarian and all. So I had to eat, like, stick to, like, soupy stuff and watery stuff, really soft food for the past week or so. Because it was so bad. And it kind of sucks that, like, my obligations require me to talk. I'm a social work intern at a high school. So I'm required to talk. I provide therapy to high schoolers. I have individual counseling sessions. I hold group sessions. I talk with my supervisor about things. I talk and talk and talk. You know, my part-time job, I'm a classroom tutor at elementary school. So I'm helping third graders and fourth graders and kindergartners, you know, do better with their classwork. And what does that require? Talking, talking, talking. Tutoring requires me to talk. And it hurt really badly. It's a lot better now. It's healed so much at this point that now I can do a blog and not worry about it. Feel really grateful to be eating a salad today. Really grateful. But yeah, I think I'm slowly getting used to it. Last week was kind of brutal in that like I didn't really manage my time all that well. So what ended up happening was there was an assignment. There's every week there are these things called process recordings, and I'll talk about that in another video. But I have to turn in two process recordings a week. These are very time-consuming projects, by the way. Process recording is something that only social workers have to do to become a social worker. It's unique to our field, but like I don't think that's something to boast about. It's just process recordings. Yeah, I failed to turn my process recordings in last week. Yeah, I got berated by my supervisor for that. Or in time, actually. Like, I ended up, so, out of time, like, the day of supervision, I sent it in. But it was, supervisor was not happy, was not pleased. And, you know, understandably so. So I deserved that. You know, I think I was really preoccupied with, like, so much stuff that was due from classes. Like, there were these, like, two presentations I had to do. One presentation about my internship, another presentation about, like, using Freud's psychodynamic theories to analyze and assess this imagined, you know, hypothetical client, whatever. That was, like, the presentation, the group presentation thing. That took a lot of time to do, so I was, like, over-swamped last week. I think I'm getting better at, you know, managing time and all that. Now so much that I actually have time to just sit down and do a whole bunch of blogs, video blogs, where I talk in front of the camera and update you guys on, well, this is to update you guys on how my life is doing. I also have a bunch of other videos in mind that I'll upload. So today I'm just going to be recording a whole bunch of videos. So you'll probably see a lot of videos in which I wear this shirt and wear this tie, but it's all shot on the same day. I might upload it at different days, but it's, you know, that's what happened. That's the explanation, and you got it here if you ever watch this. But yeah, the title of this video, like, of this update is being a social work rookie, in a way. It's interesting to me because I have a bachelor's in social work, so I've gone through 4 years of college with social work training already. But, you know, even with that, I still feel like, you know, I'm barely learning the ropes of this stuff. I mean, I do think that I have a lot of good skills from all the experiences I've accrued at, you know, as working as a canvasser, working as a tutor to underprivileged students, working in a homeless shelter, and working in an environment where I'm serving the clients such as, you know, people with mental health issues, people living with HIV and AIDS, people with substance abuse issues, people who are homeless, people who are about to be homeless. You know, that's kind of my experience working with those kind of clients. And now I'm in a new kind of setting. I'm in a school setting, and I'm working with ninth graders. And, you know, in a lot of ways, like, the things I do, a lot of the skills that I've come to use in the past are transferable to school social work. But it feels rather new that I'm working with, you know, clients who are not necessarily adults, but they're not children. They're, like, in this stage where developing. So there's a lot of things, I think, that feel different about that. It has its own unique set of challenges, as it would. I'm used to working with older clients, like really older clients, but not like old clients, not like geriatric clients, which I think are, that's an interesting set of social work as well. But most of the clients that I work with, you know, 50s, 40s, 30s, sometimes in their 60s. I think a few times I work with clients that were like, you know, early 20s, even late teens, like 19 or 18. But most of my clients in school are 14 years old. Some are 16 because they were held back. Most of them are 14. But it's not even that. That's not the reason why, like, you know. But I do feel like I'm really rusty on being a social worker. There was a bad judgment call I made last week, so that's kind of like what makes me feel this way. And it didn't occur to me that it was a bad judgment call until today. And Wednesdays I have my supervision session with my supervisor. And, you know, we talk about cases, we talk about things of that nature. And we talked about this client. I'm just like, it's like, you know, I told my supervisor about it, and supervisor kind of, you know, was very insightful about it. And I was like, oh man, really? Yeah, you're totally right. Like, I totally overlooked that. That was a really, really bad judgment call. I need to rectify that as soon as possible. So I'm taking the steps now to kind of start rectifying that. Not going to go into too much detail for the sake of confidentiality and all that. But not that you would know, because it's highly unlikely. But it's a case that's still being worked on. So yeah, I'm not at this point not comfortable sharing that publicly. But what I will say is that it does in some ways involve the concept of trauma. So like what the client experienced, I kind of went like, okay. You know, I kind of was concerned, but I felt the issue was addressed. But then it dawns on me that, like, no, this is a really, thinking about it, it can be a really traumatic thing for the student. So I should have, it's a very time sensitive thing too. So I really should have addressed it directly to that person, even with the issue of confidentiality and all that kind of muddled water that I, like, kind of made myself too preoccupied with. But there's definitely a lot of things about this field there's a lot of ethical dilemmas. I think social work is just full of ethical dilemmas. It's what makes the field very interesting, and oftentimes very, very rewarding, but at the same time, on the flip side of the coin, extremely challenging. It's like, you know, the way, you know, when I have my supervision session, like, sometimes I have this issue of, like, really missing the supervisor that I had before in my previous internship years ago. And I had such a really, I felt like I had a really good relationship where, like, you know, her supervisor style, like, supervisory style really worked on me. And it really pushed me. So, and motivated me and such. But, like, this relationship, not so much, but, like, I really do find her feedback to be so insightful. And I'm just like, man, like, I wonder, like, I'm wanting to get to that level where I see that, you know, I see the pieces of the puzzle the way she does and try to come up with responses that addresses that way better than I'm currently doing. So in a way, it makes sense why, you know, we have this kind of training for social workers. It's very important, and I'm really glad in that sense that I'm in a two-year program and not in a one-year program. Not that I qualify for, because the thing is with social work, if you have a bachelor's in social work, you can get into a program in which you can get your master's in 1 year. I didn't qualify for that simply because that's something to do with my GPA wasn't high enough, and it also has something to do with I withdrew from two courses, and withdrawal automatically disqualifies you from being enrolled into that program. But now I'm starting to be kind of skeptical of the one-year program. Like, is that really enough training for a potential social worker? I'm not so sure anymore, because even after, you know, 4 years of social work training, granted it's undergrad training, it's not grad-level social work education, but even so, undergrad still requires internship and having to do POPs project and all that. Even after all that, like, I'm still feel like I'm like, maybe it's because it's a new realm. Maybe it's because it's the type of social work I have never considered before and never done before. Maybe that's why I feel like a social work rookie. But I do wonder, like, if this feeling would also transfer over if I was put in a social work setting where I'm much more familiar with. Even then, I think there will still be ethical dilemmas that are pretty challenging to face. And, you know, I kind of sometimes I think about it, just like, I have no idea what to do. That's what supervisor is there for. It's a good self-awareness for me. Like, I know, like, I'm kind of in over my head on some levels, and I'm still learning a lot. And actually, no matter where you are at, you know, it's always important to be learning, to be striving, to be improving yourself. But I think I'm still at this stage where I'm just like, I'm over here, but I kind of want to be here. So I'm slowly getting there, but I think it will take quite a good amount of time before my reaction time. You know, we call that like being self-aware after the fact or during the moment. You know, you want that response time to be as quick as possible. You want that insight to kick in right when you need it. And getting there requires a lot of practice, and practice has definitely is not there yet. So I'm still working hard to do that. The only thing that I really have to focus on right now is just waking up in time, completing my obligations in time, and just not being too idle or, you know, to get distracted by other things. Time management, I think, is going to be a really big key issue there. But yeah, that's pretty much my update regarding this. And so far, like, I think I have a couple of videos in mind. I think I recently started talking about, like, psychology versus social work. So that's been an interesting topic. There's still some stuff I want to talk more about that. And they're probably going to end up being just as long, each video being, like, I don't know, 14 minutes, 10 minutes. I talk a lot. So that's going to happen. What else do I, like... There's a whole bunch of stuff. Some bunch of random videos that you're going to see from me. So that's going to happen. But so far, this has been just my update on what I'm doing in life. I'm not going to talk about that. But yeah, so that's it. Hope you guys found this to be interesting. Sure. All right. Take care.